Hello, my name is Patrick Vidature. I've got to respond to a question often asked about what kind of business can you do on a piece of land. Now, the question is, how big is a piece of land? If you've got a few square miles, you probably do a ranch. If you've got 100 acres, you probably do a farm. If you've got 1 acre, you still have to do maybe a farm. And also that depends on how much money you've got. If you've got, looking at land, the perspective from a property developer. A property developer sees the value of a piece of land worth an acre as about 500 million shillings. It depends on its location, if it is in Kololo, or 50 million shillings if it is in Luwero, or 10 million shillings if it is, maybe even less than 10 million shillings if it is in Bundubugyo. So you've got to look at what you want to do with that land as a property developer. And a farmer will look at it from a completely different lens. A farmer will see, what can I get out of the soil when I plant in that land? Or what can I get out of looking after my cows or my goats or my pigs there? And his calculation is completely different. One calculation is at this level, the other calculation is at this level. So you've got to think about what you're going to do with the land. If it's in a prime location and you can do business of trading and you can have a market there, maybe you create many small shops like a market. Or if it's in a place like downtown, you make a shopping mall. That's why you see small pieces of land in downtown go for a very high price. So it all depends on location, the lenses you're looking at it, what is your perspective, are you a businessman, are you a farmer, are you a property investor? And also it looks at how much money you've got, how much can you raise. Now, if you have only so much equity, land is an easy piece that you can leverage, you can borrow against it. So if you have half the money and you've got the land, the bank will probably give you the rest of the money because you've got the land. Whereas if you have a very good idea and you have half the money and you go to the bank but you don't have security, the bank will probably not give you the balance. Your money is your money. They want something additional. So it's good to leverage land because it's easy to utilize. But remember, when you do so, you are risking it, because once you put it in, until you've paid the very last penny, the land does not belong to you and probably the business too. The bank would have the first charge. So be very cautious about borrowing, especially when you're beginning a business, and borrowing from institutions that charge interest, because they compound their interest when you don't pay, and that can grow very quickly and become a nightmare. If you've got that skill, understand how business works, understand the profitability, understand the cash flow, because cash flow is important. You must pay on time whether you borrow it from. Then you can leverage, and that is something you do when I call that secondary stage of business. But at the beginning, try to manage your cash flow as frugally as possible and manage your expenses. I hope that helps to give you some indication of what you can do with a piece of land, and I'd like to see people utilizing land all over the country, especially my brothers and sisters in the north, where you have huge tracts of very beautiful land that are grossly underutilized. Yes, it's your land and you're worried, but nobody's going to carry it away. It will always be your land. If you can negotiate and write documents, give leases that are useful and mutually beneficial, unlock that potential in that land. Because Uganda is probably operating on 3/4 of its capacity, or less. A quarter of Uganda is completely underutilized, and that's mainly in the north and a part of the east, extreme east. I hope my tips are useful to you. Thank you.